Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. In today's video, we are diving again into the cool LLM development framework AutoGen from Microsoft. We will try to put a web UI to AutoGen to make its output more readable. So let's get back to revisit the AutoGen. What is AutoGen? It's essentially a way to get these assistant-like agents to communicate with each other based on specific roles they play to complete complex tasks. Imagine that you have an app where different parts talk to each other to solve a problem. That's pretty much what these agents do. And they allowed you, the human, to jump into the conversation without skipping a beat. There are a couple of things that really make AutoJ attractive. First of all, it's packed with conversation patterns. These patterns range from group chat, joint chat, to even hierarchical interactions. Plus, AutoGen provides a bunch of program templates you can leverage and implement right into your work. The second thing that's super neat about AutoGen is how it works with other frameworks and techniques, like LangChain, function calling, RAG, and more. This means that the agents get an extra boost of knowledge, making them even smarter. If you're looking for a detailed development guide of AutoGen, I'm not going to go deeper into that today, but check out my previous video for the necessary background information you need about AutoGen. Let's move to the point. AutoGen's output is super rich in context, with conversations from different agents all lined up together. It can get a bit tricky to read, especially with code snippets and format text. That's why I want to show you how to use Panel to give AutoGen a slick, checkbox-style user interface. Panel looks like any web app framework. It's open source and focused on displaying data in a way that's easy to digest. Originally for data experts who never want to wade into deep web development, it's a Python library perfect for creating dashboards and interactive web apps. The cool thing is with its recent update, Panel 1.3 has started offering chatbot components just like the other frameworks. Panel integrates smoothly with packages like LangChain, offering widgets that help with building AI human chats. But I've got to tell you, the thing that really makes Panel stand out for me is now it handles chained responses. It's perfect for what AutoGen is built for, which is those multi-agent conversations. Let's have a quick look at this. Panel's chained response feature can handle multiple roles with custom names and avatars all in one conversation interface. That means when you plug it into AutoGen, each agent's output go right where it needs to be in that chat. So that's what we've got on tap. Without further ado, let's jump right into the code. Before we start programming AutoGen's UI, let's have a quick walkthrough of Panel's new chat interface library. To create the simplest Panel chatbot without generative capabilities, we only have to do very few steps. First, install or upgrade the Panel packages to the latest version, that should be over 1.3. Import and define the style of widgets to materials. Create a chat interface that initiates the Panel's chat components implicitly. Then one of the most critical enablers of the chatbot is to add a callback to handle the user's input. Any return of a message string or structure objects will be automatically displayed on the conversation interface. Here we echo the user with their content. Okay, now we can use the Panel command, Panel serve, to run the web server. When you receive some messages like this, that means the Panel server is successfully running on the local host with default port 5006. Now you can visit the URL on your web browser, then you can find the web server is successfully running. If you would like to custom the name and avatar of more bots, you can return a dict object by providing this information. Now we are going to integrate AutoGen messaging into the Panel framework to demonstrate a multi-agent conversation UI. Firstly, install the AutoGen package. For easy implementation, I will use an existing project from AutoGen's repo called Group Chat Research. which performs research processing with multi-agent group chat. Let's configure the LLM as the latest GPT-4 turbo model for auto generation. Then copy and modify the source code from notebook of the group chat research project to define the roles of the chat participants: admin, engineer, scientist, planner, executor, and critic. There are a few modifications I've made for the admin role in order to make it more autonomous. For example, it will end the conversation by receive terminate and be equipped with GPT-4 Turbo to automate approval of other agents' requests. After all these roles are created, we can consolidate them into a manager. Now we should initial the panel's chat interface with the callback function. In the callback function, the query message will trigger the entire chat of AutoJ. Once the user types the query into the input box on the panel UI, the admin role will send it to chat manager. The chat manager will select the most suitable role to handle. That is the core design idea of AutoJ. To facilitate the messages in panel UI, we should add another two steps. The first one is that insert print function, print messages to each agent as reply func for print out the message it receives in real time. The second step is to define the print messages function to execute the print of messages with the proper agent name and avatar. Here we define each roles with different avatar and using the chat interface send function to send it on the panel's interface. Okay, that's it. Now we can run the server by the panel command, panel serve. Try to send a message to prompt the chat. Let's try find papers on open source language models from archive in last week and create a markdown table of different domains. If your program runs successfully like mine, the output from AutoGen is pretty much more readable than before with code snippets, tables, and a clear sequence of the entire chat. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.